Hi, I'm Kim Jamieson-Hirst of Chatterbox Quilts, and today I want to show you some of my favorite hand embroidery books. Some of these are reference books that I refer to again and again, and other ones I find are great for inspiration. One of the ones I look at and refer to all the time is Judith Baker Montano's Embroidery and Crazy Quilt Stitch Tool. Now, there's a lot of great things about this book. First, of course, the information in it is wonderful, but I like it because it's small. And it will actually set up and it's coil bound, so you can just flip over to get to the stitch that you want. So that works very well. The other thing that she has in this book is at the back, she has combination stitches. So this gives you ideas for what you can do to actually put different stitches together and create something really wonderful. So this is always close by me when I'm embroidering in case I'm wanting to try a new stitch or I've forgotten how to do one that I want to add to my project. She also has another book called Elegant Stitches. This is an illustrated stitch guide and source book of inspiration. Now this is more for crazy quilting, so there is some silk ribbon embroidery as well in here, but it's very interesting. Lots of great ideas, and she shows you some of her projects that she's done. And in the back, again, there's a combination of stitches. What's a bit different with this book is the fact that she actually has an actual stitch. For example, Lazy Daisy stitch, and different variations you could do with that one. So it's kind of indexed, if you will, that way. So it makes it easy to find. So if I'm looking for something to do with a chain stitch, for example, I could flip to that area and see what combination she would use with a chain stitch and other stitches. So another great book to have, both as reference and inspiration, this one. Of course, if you know me, you know I love Aimee Ray's books. And I have all her books, but the first one I think I got was Doodle Stitching. This is Fresh and Fun Embroidery for Beginners. So this one, again, has lots of great little projects in it and ideas in the back. She also talks about different stitches that she uses and shows you how to make them, so that's good. What I like about her books is that she has different designs. They're always a whole variety, from little kids things to more elegant ones, so that's great. Different projects in this one. The Doodle Stitching the Motif collection has, again, projects and information. It has a CD with it, which is cool because you can take those designs and print them off on your computer and enlarge them or make them smaller if you want. What I like about this book is how in the back she has them categorize the different designs into sections. So, for example, trees and leaves, under the sea. So you can see the individual little designs at the back, not with a project attached to them necessarily, but you can take those and you can make them into whatever you want to do with them. So you can combine them into your own projects. So that's a great idea. Another one I have that I think this is very interesting. This is Three-Dimensional Embroidery Stitches by Pat Trott. It's an older book. But what I like about this is that the stitches are, as she says in the title, three-dimensional. So she has some great ideas for making, for example, rocks. She does a lot of landscapes and she tells you how to make little rocks. You actually will take nylons, stockings, and you will actually pad them with little bits of batting, or she uses other items too, but you can actually make these little rocks and then put them together in her pieces. Really effective. The stitches she's using are actually three-dimensional as well, of course. Just trying to find something. So here, for example, here's where she's made these little rocks to use in her landscape here. And she also uses paint and other things to color her background fabric when she's doing her landscape. So you can see there's one there, for example, the rockery garden. So this is great inspiration, I find. I haven't tried some of her stitches yet, but I certainly want to, and I think there's a lot of great ideas in this book too. So if you have an opportunity to pick up that one, it's a great addition to your library. So those are just a few of the books that I really like in my library and ones I refer to again and again.